It was Winky Wright who was moving up 6 pounds in weight to fight at 160 pounds for the first time, and some felt that might be an advantage for Trinidad. But as you can see here, the numbers were very even. Trinidad 1 year younger at 32, a half inch taller. The arm length advantage, measured from the armpit to the end of the fist, belonged to Winky Wright and may have been significant in the fight. They both weighed in right at 160 and looked sensational. They entered the ring 1 pound apart, but as they faced off against each other, as you'll see, it appeared that it was Winky Wright who had more stature. Let's go back to last Saturday night at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Roy Jones, there's enormous mutual respect between these two fighters. They don't dislike each other. If anything, they like each other. Does that make it more difficult?
No, that doesn't make it more difficult, but I like what Winky's doing already by feinting at Tito and using the jab. But no, that doesn't make it more difficult. You're competitors. It doesn't matter whether you like a person or hate them. You're competitors.
During pre-fight introductions by ring announcer Michael Buffer, Tito Trinidad emerged from his knot of people in his corner of the ring, went to the center of the ring, waved and smiled at Wright as if to say, we're about to have some fun.
Well, Tito got to be smart. Make sure he fights the right type of fight.
Double jab by Wright, misses with the left cross. Double jab again. Wright occupying Trinidad early with his jab. And as they face each other in the ring, there is no question, there's no size difference here. If anything, Wright is bigger across the shoulders.
Yep, and the one thing I don't like that Tito is doing is moving to Wright's left hand.
I believe that what Trinidad is doing is that he believes he can box with Wright and let his power take care of itself in order. I don't believe he's trying to stand and deliver big punches.
He throws a right hand that Wright blocks with his left glove. He throws a left hook that Wright blocks with his right glove. And Wright fires his jab right up the center of Trinidad's guard. Hard to imagine Felix Trinidad is going to stay in a jabbing contest all night long with Winky Wright.
No, he won't win a jabbing contest.
Can't win it. Wright sneaks his right hand past Trinidad's left. Trinidad more tentative with his jab. Wright firing hits.
Trinidad trying to get the measure of that right hand, which is dominating this first round.
Interesting little lecture from Nady on keeping their feet clear. Southpaw against a conventional fighter. Sometimes the front feet will tangle. That's just the way it goes.
Usually they say the fighter that has his foot to the outside has the advantage because he has the other guy trapped in his power range. Here, I think Winky has the advantage because it's making Tito go where he wants Tito to go.
No evidence yet that Trinidad's just going to be able to huff and puff and blow Wright's house down. Instead, they fought a boxing match in the first round, and if you have to give an edge to somebody, it's the boxer. That's not terribly surprising, is it?
Nope.
And when we go to Trinidad's corner, where they'll speak Spanish, our interpreter is Ray Torres.
Give me your mouth, please.
Tranquilo,
Tito. Nice and calm.
La izquierda alta para que paremos allá. ¿Está bien? Casi no te han llegado, pero yo sé que podemos...
He is in heavy with the left hand.
Everything's okay.
Thank you. Keep your left hand up. Give him some water.
You're cool.
Just one.
Both sides.
One camera.
Good jab. Keep, stay offensive.
Stress your conditions.
Stay offensive.
Not working. We just want to win every round.
Let's go, guys.
Winky Wright fighting with the residue of an infected ingrown hair just on the left side of his neck there. He was treated both Monday and Wednesday here in Las Vegas. Received antibiotics Wednesday night. Ring medical authorities here satisfied that there is no problem facing either fighter because of the infection on Wright's neck. Round one given to Wright by Harold Letterman. Let's see if Tito Trinidad tries to get closer in round two.
He's got to find a way to either block that jab or come over it with his left hook. Otherwise, he's going to be standing outside all night trying to find space to deliver his harder punches.
I don't like his body language. And right now, the way he's fighting, he only has one plan. That's not Winky out, and that's not going to happen.
You don't think so?
No.
He hasn't really caught Winky with a flush shot yet. Yeah, but
look how off balance he is, and he's telegraphing his shots because he's just trying to knock out. Winky's cool, just jab him all night. Winky should be able to beat him just like that with his jab. Don't take no chances, curve up and jab him.
Doesn't look all that different from the two Mosley fights so far, and Winky Wright won them easily.
Yep.
He is tattooing Tito with the jab. Now he adds the left cross. Trinidad hasn't made his jab a factor. Wright's jab is owning the fight. Great left hand by Winky Wright. Misses with that one, but shows that he can pop it right through Trinidad's guard. Hard right hand by Trinidad, partially blocked.
Wright has Trinidad fighting behind him. He's
hard body
all
shot
the contact
by Trinidad, and now left hook upstairs. That looks like the direction Tito would have to go. Begin to attack the body. And he does it again. And a straight right hand into Tito's mouth by Wright, and he does it again. Winky Wright appears to be at the very top of his game in the first 5 minutes of action here.
And normally, like I said, he rises to the occasion.
What he's done in recent fights, he's always been able to fight just a little bit above the level of his opponent. That's why he's only had 6 stoppages in his last 25 fights over 10 years.
Look at him.
But it's been good enough.
Now, Tito has blood on the nose from the left hand.
Jab and the left hand. They both landed on Tito's nose. Left hook upstairs and to the body by Trinidad. Wright downstairs. And Winky Wright felt those shots. So Trinidad finally mounts some effective offense in the last minute of round two. But he hasn't solved the puzzle of how to stop Wright from tattooing him with the jab.
Okay, your hands up. You gotta try a little bit faster. Come on, you gotta get closer. Come on, a little closer we need to get.
Here you see the punch that's totally dominating and controlling this fight. That right jab right there, you see it come out of fake. You see it come straight off top. It goes over his guard, between his guards, over Felix jab, under Felix's jab. The right jab is totally dominating, and this is just the first two rounds, and you see that many jabs landing already.
Now, what is Tito doing wrong? I mean, theoretically, a southpaw jab ought to be able to be neutralized by a conventional fighter and vice versa.
Well, Tito stands too much, puts too much weight on his front foot. See, his front foot is almost flat. He'll never get the way of a jab like that because his weight is always on his front foot.
This is what Hopkins proved.
Exactly.
That because of Tito's footwork, he puts himself in positions where you can counter his hard shots and he doesn't have any chance to answer back.
Exactly. And that's why he can't get rid of his jab right now. And he's going to get discouraged pretty soon because he's only had one fight back. And the last time he remembered this feeling was against Bernard Hopkins. And it's not hard for him to remember that feeling.
And he got discouraged easily against Hopkins, or seemed to. So we'll be watching carefully to see if Tito can bring himself to a higher level as Wright continues to do what he wants to do. Hard left hand over the top by Wright. And Wright seems to stun Trinidad with that left hand. Good body shot by Tito. And the right hand splits the guard of Wright.
And notice Tito seems to stumble every time he punches, whereas Wright has a very rock solid foundation under him.
Tito has a history of unsteady feet in the first few rounds, which resulted in 7 early round knockdowns by opponents in his career, including the third round knockdown by Mayorga in the comeback fight. Look at Wright just stick the jab right up the middle, almost like it's a sparring session.
Yeah, the Trinidad corner gave Trinidad bad information. They told him to get closer, and he's getting hit even more by this jab. And he's totally thrown off of his game right now because of that right jab.
Some questioned the advice that Papa Trinidad gave to his son during the Hopkins fight. It'll be interesting to see what happens here, where he seems to be tactically outgunned. Now, there's a straight right hand. Left hook to the body. But still, by getting closer, he's bringing himself more into range for Wright's jab.
Well, but he's got to get inside the jab, not just standing right in front of him, which is easier said than done, and certainly easier from ringside than in the ring.
Right hand blocked by Winky. The body shots have been the most effective attack so far for Trinidad, who's getting his hands under Wright's elbows and landing to the ribcage.
What Wright is doing is he got his hands up so high that he's not showing Trinidad a target. And if Trinidad doesn't see a target, sometimes he doesn't punch. And as you see right now, his punch output is nothing like he said he wanted it to be, because he doesn't see a clear shot.
Papa Trinidad said over and over, we are technically superior to Wright. Well, that doesn't turn out to be the case. So what's plan B?
Take some air. Since keep going to the way you're doing, but a little closer. Are you listening to me? I said closer. Nice and cool. Come on, you need to get closer. Now we're going to stick him.
Beautiful job. Don't get careless with the movement. I know he can't hurt you. He doesn't look strong at all tonight. But don't get careless.
Man, stay up, champ.
All right? You're the boss in here. Right out there in the middle with the jab. Back him up. When he punches, you retreat.
Hands up, champ.
You heard the comment of Dan Birmingham, who has been the trainer of Winky Wright since he was an amateur, 18 or more years ago, saying he doesn't look strong tonight. Do you agree with that, Roy Jones?
I definitely do. He never really looks that strong to me in a way, but he definitely looks even more off tonight. And I think Tito has been through so many tough fights, man. You know, the layoff did him some good, but he's so front foot heavy that he can't avoid anything. And these jabs have started to take a toll on him already.
It's becoming a technical mismatch unless Tito can come up with something else. Harold Letterman, how do you have it through three?
okay, Jim. 30-27, 3-0. Winky Wright, tremendous attention. Larry S. But Tito Trinidad, he's doing wrong. But I'll continue with it after this flurry. But, okay. Jim, listen, he's circling the wrong way for 3 rounds. You don't go to your right against the guy who's a southpaw. You go to your left. It's unnatural for Tito to go to the right, and he can't absolutely get it with you.
Tito mounted his biggest rally of the fight, brought the crowd out of their seats with a couple of big body shots and a left hook, and now Winky has turned it around and done the same thing.
Well, Winky is at the advantage right now because he sees now that he can handle the guy that everybody thought for so long was better than him. He's on a confident high. He would not get tired now. He's in hard heaven. This is what a guy wants.
And he tasted one big left hook flush and didn't move.
And so he's fine. But I told you the size differential was not going to be a problem for him.
Well, in fact, he looks like he's a stronger guy right now.
There's the jab again. And again. He misses that time, because Tito backed away.
Harold Letterman made a very important point when he said that Tito is moving to his right, which is the wrong way to move against the southpaw unless you're going to stay back and stay outside.
The trickle of blood has begun again for Trinidad. Ironically, Oscar De La Hoya moved the wrong way all night long against southpaw Pernell Whitaker and managed to win the fight anyway. But Tito Trinidad won't help himself moving the wrong way against Winky Wright.
No, he won't. And Oscar De La Hoya was on the uprise. He was a younger guy coming to take over the older guy. He had a lot more energy. In this case, they're a year apart. That's not the case.
Body shot and a straight right down the pike by Trinidad. Crowd gets excited sometimes, even though Trinidad's punches are blocked. They're so anxious for Tito to do something big. Tito missed the left hook, right landed the right. And now Winky goes back to popping and popping and popping Tito with the jab as there are 10 seconds remaining in the round. Trinidad had one big rally. Was it enough to win him the round? Or was it right again because of the predominance of his jab? You are watching Winky Wright and Felix Trinidad on tape from 1 week ago in Las Vegas. There's a look at the skyline of Chicago across Lake Michigan on a beautiful, crystal clear night in the Windy City as we get ready for Indianapolis native Layman Brewster to defend his WBO heavyweight title belt against Andrew Galata, originally from Warsaw, Poland, but for the last 15 years a resident of the city of Chicago, Poland. Galata, I should say, stands to have Chicago's huge Polish-American population behind him, many of them, and the United Center to root for their man tonight. So it's Galata's best chance ever to win the heavyweight title belt he's been seeking for 9 years. It's coming along later on this show.
Don't let him get any momentum hitting into your body like that. Even on the gloves, all you got to do is step back.
This guy's scared of you. You got him intimidated. Keep your offense working. Keep busting him with the jab. Show him a little bit different now, something. Feint the jab, hook, left hand, everything we've been working on. Get in, get out. Bar's right under your hand.
Breathe to the body, man.
You can't move me.
I know.
Breathe.
Look at that, champ. Just try.
Beautiful job. Look at the shape you're in, man. It's incredible.
Hey, you see Tito with his right, left hook to the body. Another left hook to the body, then a hook to the head, but it just, as a middleweight, just doesn't seem to have the power to even bother Winky Wright, and that's not good for him.
Well, none of those punches really land clean.
Right, he hasn't landed a clean shot on him for four rounds. A clean, hard shot.
Through round four, and how's this for a copy box window into what's going on here? Through four rounds, Winky Wright is averaging 49 jabs thrown per round. Trinidad's only throwing 37 total punches per round. Wright is just owning the fight with his jab. George Foreman seated in the stands tonight. Back in the day when George was sitting in your chair, Roy, he used to always say, this sport is easy if you have a jab.
And Winky is showing you that tonight. But the thing about it, that's Winky's best punch.
Trinidad counter-punching right and landing a right hand. And again, Trinidad bangs to the hip, the belt line of Winky Wright. Winky's just waiting for Jay Nady to begin disciplining Trinidad for that.
Trinidad should have been, a long time ago, should have been told to put his left hand on top of Winky's right hand. Therefore, that would nullify that jab.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm wondering about, and I've asked about before, why he doesn't use his left hand to try to nullify that right jab and then work with his right hand.
He's not just controlling Tito with the jab. There are moments when he's humiliating him with it.
He hurt him with it, actually, I believe.
And you heard Dan Birmingham, the trainer of Wright, say, he's scared of you. That would be an amazing turnaround in the eyes of boxing fans if it were Tito who was scared of Winky.
He ain't scared of him. He's just discouraged right now because he can't make nothing happen. He can't get into the fight. Winky has not let him even get into the fight.
Wright lands easily. For Trinidad, it's all scratch and sniff. Well, there are going to be some welts on Winky's elbows and arms, but nothing much is reaching the ribcage. Second warning for low blows. And Trinidad's already apparently behind on the cards. Losing points won't help. it's a little early to say that Tito needs a knockout, but, I mean, what is going to change this?
Well, this has been discouraging for him and to him because his game is a little different. Now, he's going to left like he should, but...
Lands a left hook. Did Trinidad. Right. Taking a few seconds off there. Blocks a right hand with his elbow and begins sticking the jab again.
Every time Tito starts to go to that right, he gets caught with that jab again. Watch. Every single time he moves to the right, he gets caught with that jab.
Right hook by Winky Wright. Varies the attack slightly. Fires that right hook again. Backs up. Waits to land the jab, but the round comes to a close.
Easy fight.
All right, he lowered his guard. Now it's our turn. We're going to go for it now. That's it, from now on. A little bit more and we got him. But we got to get through more punches and get a little closer.
Good work, champ. Tune in May 23 for the next Real Sports with Bryant Gumbel. Among the stories, Armin Katayan investigates whether the poker craze is developing a generation of problem gamblers.
Your hand won't hurt him when you hit him with it.
Let's get that water back there, guys.
Winky Wright is an all-around athlete who says he's good at everything and not great. Tonight he's been very, very good.
CompuBox numbers
fighting.
In round five. Wright, 21 out of 57. Trinidad, 4 out of 46. Tito simply cannot get anything going offensively. And still, Tito's father, Papa Trinidad, says to him between rounds, oh, we're fine. Everything's in great shape. Little bit more and you've got him.
He's almost where we want him at. Where is that?
Trinidad does try to get closer. It's clear. And Wright uses that as an opportunity to pop the jab. Big left hook by Trinidad, upstairs and downstairs. Winky backs off. You heard Dan Birmingham tell Winky, don't let him hit you. All you got to do is back up. That left hook was blocked.
The jab is killing Tito. Look at that. He just cannot get away with it.
Trinidad's lucky he didn't get a point deducted for the low blow there. Good little pop by Wright with the right hand. Jab, jab, jab. Trinidad reaching with his right. He hasn't made the straight right hand a factor in any way, shape, or form against a southpaw fighter. And if you have trouble landing the straight right hand, you're not in good shape to set up the left hook.
No, you're not. And once again, he's not moving to his left. He's going straight down the pipe or he's moving to his right. And that's why he's getting caught so much. And he's trying to land these big punches to knock right out.
As he gets more frustrated, he wings shots more and more. The more you wing shots, the more Winky can land up the middle. Another perfectly blocked body shot by Wright after he landed a right hook and an uppercut. And he sticks the jab in Trinidad's face. One, two, three, four more times. Tito Trinidad can't stop Winky Wright's jab. There's no way.
He ain't trying to. That's what gets me. He's not trying to stop the jab.
Yeah. You would have thought that they would have come up with some alternative strategy that would have said, okay, if you're having a hard time with the jab, do this.
They thought they were going to blow Winky away with power. That's the only explanation for what's going on.
And then, like you said earlier, they never have a plan B.
And right now, Wright is systematically breaking Trinidad down, much the way Bernard Hopkins did, although in a different style.
Felix Trinidad has 35 knockout wins in his career. Only four of them came after the sixth round. And we're after the sixth now.
Million in the bank, baby. Every round's a million. I'm telling you, this guy ready. You looking good?
doing, champ?
That's his blood. I got you.
Breathe me.
Relax. Relax.
Slow your heartbeat
relax.
Down.
Relax. Relax.
You looking beautiful, man.
Beautiful, man. Wait. Please don't stand fucking
still.
I know, but I can see.
But, yeah, but at least drop.
Yeah, but at least drop a little bit. Drop and look for a left hand. Please don't start. Stand in line of fire. You're making this fight so one-sided, man. Keep it up.
Keep it up. Body shot, man. Hurry.
Okay, nice and calm. Easy.
You see Winky with that jab, left hand, right down the middle, and this is happening because Tito is right in front of him, straight up. They told him to get close up, straight left lead. He can't get out the way of anything because he's right in front of the man.
Nobody can beat Winky Wright from right in front of him. He holds up his right hand like a medieval knight's guard in front, and he comes forward and pressures you. You've got to be at an angle to beat Winky Wright. A straight-in, straight-out attacker doesn't have a chance. Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim. 60 to 54, six rounds to nothing, Winky Wright. Jim, I saw something in the sixth round that I never thought I'd saw in a million years. Winky Wright actually backed Tito Trinidad up. He just jammed him to death, and Tito was going straight backwards. I mean, he's scoring effectively constantly with that right jab, piling up the points, blocking Tito's best shots, and just absolutely beat them up with the jab.
Before this fight, Winky Wright's most confident statement was, my only fear is that I'll beat Tito so badly that I won't get to collect that big check for a rematch. Who would have thought that it might be true?
If this continues for the rest of the fight, you can be assured there'll be no rematch. First of all, who would want to see it? Much less have to go in there and get beaten up again.
It's a clinic. Remains a clinic.
It's definitely it.
And it's such a clinic that you almost forget that the guy in front of Wright is the most dangerous one-punch puncher in the sport. Of course, after everything he's taken in the first six rounds, is he still the most dangerous one-punch puncher in the sport?
No, he's not. He's not close to the most dangerous one-punch puncher in the sport. As a matter of fact, he's one of the most discouraged punchers in the sport.
You know, and I would like to add this, guys, which is, as a welterweight, he may have been the most dangerous one-punch puncher. But it took him about 200 clean punches to chop Mayorga down. And I don't know that he is he's a good puncher, but I don't know that he's a devastating puncher at this weight.
And before the night is over, if this keeps up, Felix Trinidad's face is going to show you how good Winky Wright is.
Well, the problem is they came out to pressure a pressure fighter. They didn't come out to box. They didn't come out to outbox a boxer. They came out to fight a pressure fighter against a pressure fighter. You're not going to out-pressure Winky Wright. That's what he does. His best punches is right jab and the straight left. Now, you stand right in front of him, that's where those punches are.
You don't have a prayer. I mean, I just think that, you know, you could beat him maybe from angles on either side, but in front of him, he's impregnable. The defense is too good and the attack is too quick.
And that's what he's been doing for years. I don't understand how they tell the man to get closer to him. And his best punching, the shorter point to any distance is a straight line.
I think that it appears that Tito and his father have simply ignored who Winky Wright really is.
They're finding out.
Take a deep breath. Give me a towel. You gotta throw some punches, Tito. Give me some water. Put some water on the head. Nice and calm. Cool. Okay, hit him hard in the body.
Tito Trinidad got dismantled by Bernard Hopkins in New York. A lot of people wondered about the absence of intensity in his corner. Once again, Tito's father seems to be treating this as though, well, all right, the fight is going on and something good is going to happen sometime.
And it had me wonder, was the interpreter telling the truth?
I don't think he has any answers, but ultimately, a fighter like Trinidad has been in the ring so long has to provide the answers himself.
That's a great point. He's the one who realizes now how difficult it is to get at Winky and how hard it is to stop the attack. Straight left hand by Wright knocks Trinidad's head back.
Winky Wright never fully commits to a big punch. So he is always in good defensive position.
Yep.
And that's why in his last 25 fights, he's only stopped six fighters, none of whom you ever heard of. He's very happy to fight in this fashion. Doesn't have to throw real hard punches. Just has to have his defense ready and throw short, sharp punches.
And Tito telegraphing all his punches.
Winky Wright blocked or partially blocked all but one of those Tito Trinidad shots. And there's nothing blocking Wright. When Wright throws power punches, he stuffs them into Felix's mouth. Boom!
He hurt Tito with that left hand in.
And he hurt him with the jab, too.
Welts beginning to form under Boom. Tito's right eye.
The clinic continues.
Tito don't have an idea what's going on right now.
He's just trying to get more and more intense. He's trying to focus more and more, but he's still shooting straight shots right in front of Wright, trying to huff and puff and blow Wright's house down, and it's not going to happen.
Well, he does have a belief in his power, and that keeps him going, hoping that one punch can change the fight. It doesn't look like one punch can.
Straight left hand, perfect. Tito makes a glancing contact with the right side of Winky's head. Again, right on the belt line. Jay Nady chooses not to penalize Tito.
You don't need to.
Deducting a point at this point is non-essential.
It's a pointless penalty because this is such a well-pointed fight for Wright.
You are watching tape coverage of Winky Wright versus Felix Trinidad from 1 week ago in Las Vegas. There's a look at the Chicago skyline as we get ready to bring you live to the United Center, where Andrew Galata, originally from Warsaw, Poland, but now for the past 15 years a resident of Chicago, will go into United Center before a frenzied pro-Galata crowd to try to beat Indianapolis-born and bred Layman Brewster for Brewster's tiny slice of the heavyweight title picture. He holds one of the four heavyweight title belts, the one which is perhaps least regarded among boxing magazines and media, but nevertheless a prize that Galata greatly covets. It's his fourth chance to win one of the heavyweight title belts, and tonight he's favored against Brewster. Now let's go back to the tape.
10 seconds to steal the round. Okay. Good work. Good work.
I won.
The round's getting a little closer. You're winning every round, but as we go along, keep the jab in his face. Keep your distance. Don't stand there when he's punching. You hear me? Move your head like you did this round. Move your head like you did this round.
Come on, Tito, you gotta stick him. And when you go in, throw something.
Here you see the best two punches Winky landed, a 1-2 right flush in the face of Trinidad. That comes from Trinidad standing right in front of him. That pushed him back, that hurt him. And that's the first time Winky got a chance to put a real left hand on him the whole fight. 1-2, as best you can ask for. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that for Winky Wright.
Roy, it's been a full-scale annihilation so far. Tito is averaging four total punches landed per round. Wright is more or less landing at will. Is this the night, if it continues, that finally makes Winky Wright a superstar?
Oh, he's been a superstar This will make him a superstar.
Among fighters, he's been a superstar for a long time.
Yeah,
I mean, for fans.
Yeah, it will. But the one thing that you have to still understand is he'll have to put Tito down to really be that. And if he does put him down, that will make him that star.
Then he'll be Hopkins. Because he'll have done what Hopkins did, right?
Yep.
A star is somebody who puts behinds in the seats. It remains to be seen whether Winky, as a champion, as a conqueror of Trinidad, if he does conquer him, will attract fans. That's what a star is.
Trinidad caught right on the ear with a left hook. Trinidad is trying very hard to do something that might reverse the tide. Trinidad is still flirting with having a point taken away for low blows.
He has no other choice, Jim. That's the only shot he can land.
It's sort of like lashing line drives into foul territory. Look at Winky just popping.
You don't often see such a comprehensive beating of a fighter considered a great fighter from start to so far.
You got to remember, though, Larry, Tito is one of those fighters who had one of those quick outbursts in careers. He fought everybody on the block for a short period of time there, and it's possible that pretty much all of his fighters, the best fights have already been behind him. He's 33 years old. He's been in the toughest fights against some of the toughest fighters that came up through his time and era. And right now, I think we're seeing the outcome of some of that hard work.
Perhaps, but I don't know that there was ever a day when he could beat Winky Wright, given their styles.
Now, I'm not saying he could beat him for that. You're right. Winky hasn't had but one or two noteworthy fights, which was the Vargas fight. Like I said, he fought Bronco 1,000 times. He doesn't have any damage on him.
Well, maybe this would have looked different at 147 pounds, but you made a tremendous point earlier, Roy. Wright is, if anything, the bigger man, and it has shown here.
Yeah, he's definitely the bigger man, and that's why I said if Tito couldn't hurt him, he wouldn't have a problem. And hurting him is not what the problem is. Tito can't even hit him.
In the days before the fight, reality seemed to dawn on boxing experts, who began picking Wright with far greater frequency. And here comes the point deduction.
Jay Nady may be right in deducting a point. I don't understand why you interrupt the fight to deduct the point, why you can't do it when the round is completed.
Interesting question.
You may disadvantage the fighter who's in charge.
Winky pats Tito on the back as if to say, hey, this has been fun. Keep it up. I'd like to beat you up for three more rounds. And for the first time, a ring doctor is going to look into the corner.
That shot should not have been called low blows. Right on the belt. The belt line is above the navel. Therefore, that should not have been called a low blow. But the referee knows what he sees, and I guess he warned him about it, so we have to go with the referee's call.
Is a fighter aware when a ring doctor comes to watch him in the corner?
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Hello.
You got to hit him hard. When you hit him, you got to hit him real hard. Okay? Hard you have to hit him.
Off of what's happened so far, you wonder whether Trinidad is going to retreat back down toward the welterweight division the way De La Hoya says he might and the way Mosley already has.
Felix Trinidad has landed in single digits in every round. Wright landed 21 of 36 power shots and a one-sided ninth. Harold, how do you have it so far?
Okay, Jim. 9-0, 90-80. Winky Wright, you got to give him an extra point to round 9. To answer Larry's question, Larry, when a guy gets hit low, you got to give him a rest. So you call time and you take a point away from the offending fighter. It's that simple.
If the fighter has been hurt and looks like he needs a rest, yes. But there was no indication from Wright that he was under any distress.
Nady said it was the third time he got hit low. He took a point for low blow. That's why they call time.
And
Trinidad stuffs his jab into Wright stuffs his jab into Trinidad's mouth a couple times. Trinidad gets exercised by it and bangs his fists hard into Wright's gloves. Oh, what a right cross. Right hook. And another right hook.
I don't think I've ever seen a Winky land as many right hooks in one fight.
You know, Roy, his hands are so quick because he doesn't fully commit that Trinidad doesn't have a chance to shoot his left hook over that right jab.
Nope, not at all.
You know, normally in a conventional fighter, you want to see if the opponent can shoot a right hand over the jab. And here you want to see if he can throw the left hook. But he's never been able to time that jab all night long.
Not at all. Because he's so front foot heavy, though. All his weight is used on his front foot, so he can't time and he can't get out the way of it. See that? See where his foot weight is there? When he jabs, all of his weight is forward.
Statistically, Wright has now landed 147 jabs in the fight, and that is more than anyone has ever landed against Trinidad in a fight. Oscar De La Hoya landed 143 of them. Might have landed more if he fought the last few rounds differently, but basically, Winky Wright has dominated Felix Trinidad, if anything, even more than Bernard Hopkins did.
Yeah, he beat him worse than Bernard beat him. He kept the pressure on him all night. He's tattooing him to death. He's not hitting him quite as hard as Bernard did, but he's definitely tattooing him.
Uppercut, straight left hand. The clinic continues.
Well, he's trying to knock him out now because he realizes he can do whatever he wants to do to him, so he's gaining confidence, and he's trying to get him out of there now.
I don't think that's really on his mind, Roy. It never has been. He's always stayed within himself.
I've never seen him throw these type combinations like he's throwing tonight.
Don't you think his confidence has soared to a new high level?
This is what I'm telling Larry.
Wright looks around at the crowd as if to say, do you love me now? Do you know me now?
How you feel? Good. You're looking great. Keep busting. Don't stand there. De La Hoya let up in the last two rounds and won like you, and they give it to him. Don't let it happen to
you. Here you see what's been happening all night long. Right jab, right there. Right jab. Right jab over the top of Tito's left hand. Right jab right over the top of the left hand. Right jab right over the top of his left. Right jab again right over the top of the left. He cannot get going because he's getting caught with too many right jabs repetitively over the top of his left hand.
What a clinic.
You gotta change the fight with one good punch. You gotta hurt him. Let's go, Tito.
They know the score in Trinidad's corner. And between rounds, the crowd responded. You saw Winky Wright holding his gloves up. They chanted, Winky, Winky, Winky. Might be the first time in his career he heard that kind of love.
But he deserves it because he fought a brilliant fight tonight.
I think the name Winky has helped Winky Wright.
Felix Trinidad scored one 12th round knockout in his career. That was back in 2000 against Fernando Vargas. That was a fight that Trinidad had dominated most of the way. So to score a comeback knockout here would be a very tall order and something that has never occurred before in Trinidad's career.
Well, you got to remember, Jim, most of Trinidad's action-packed fights are against gamblers. This guy he's fighting tonight is the last guy ever to gamble with him. Therefore, he won't get a chance to get in a fight because Winky ain't going to gamble with him.
And the point that Larry makes about shorter, quicker punches that leave you in a better position to defend, I think we're going to see more of that style. It's done wonders for Vitali Klitschko in the heavyweight division.
Yep, it sure has.
When you fight this way, you have better balance, you can better defend, and you can mount your attack quicker.
You know, Tito Sr. told Tito Jr. to go after Wright because he's got to land a big punch to change the fight. But Tito has almost given up, it appears. Well, he's almost conceded the fight because he's not really, really trying.
I don't see that. I think he's still trying to land something big.
Well, he's moving in, but I don't see him really letting go.
Well, he don't see nothing, Larry. He don't see where to let it go at.
That's exactly right.
He can't see a target.
Yeah, that doesn't mean to me he's given up. It just means he can't see a target. And that's been the case since round one. But Winky can see the target clearly. Bullseye.
You know, this is an anti-climax, given the hopes that this would be a very tough, hard, close fight. But for Winky Wright, it looks like the biggest climax that he could imagine as a prize fighter.
Ronald Winky Wright moved to St. Petersburg, Florida at age 15 from Washington, D.C. Grew up in a section of St. Petersburg that produced many great athletes. Dwight Gooden, Gary Sheffield, several others, all friends of Wright. In fact, he's got many of the Tampa Bay Bucks here supporting him in the crowd tonight. Very popular with other athletes, very popular with other fighters, and about to become very popular with boxing fans.
We're still in the fight.
Okay.
Swallow. Champ, you the man! We haven't won this fight yet.
This is the last round.
De La Hoya let up and they give it to this guy.
That's right.
Don't let it happen to you.
Don't let up.
Walk away.
Okay, we'll try to do what we can. Okay, but don't get hurt.
What a great job trainer Dan Burningham has done over the years in helping to refine and sustain Winky Wright's style. If you're a guy like Dan Burningham, you're training in a non-boxing capital like Tampa or St. Pete. You need to find that one fighter who's going to lift you to public prominence. He had to wait a long time, just as Wright had to wait.
But they both got there now.
It's a huge night for both, unless something goes wrong in these last 2 minutes and 40 seconds.
I don't see that happening because Winky's not going to gamble.
And Tito is winging shots which don't have the same kind of power as his normal stuff.
Down so far.
A final flurry from Trinidad. 2 minutes to go. He tries to salvage something that hasn't been there all night long.
Nope. No target to hit.
Wright continues to come forward, continues to put the pressure on Tito. Trinidad would have lost a decision against Bernard Hopkins if the fight had gone to the final bell. He got knocked out instead. If this fight goes to the final bell, it'll be the first decision loss of Felix Trinidad's career. I'm not even contemplating the possibility that we're wrong about this, because you'll seldom see a more one-sided fight. Largely pro-Trinidad crowd, mostly quiet now in the 12th. Not even wasting the energy to try to lift their man. The outcome, cut and dry.
The crowd is chanting Winky.
The Trinidad fans are saying, what happened?
Buckled the knees of Trinidad.
Enough to probably win the round after he hadn't done much up to that point. Winky Wright so dominant over Wright and Trinidad, he can just pick his spots now.
Yeah, a round that he really doesn't even have to win.
Yep. Well, he went through most of his career without any opportunities to fight big name fighters. Now Winky Wright makes his statement. Who's next? Who wants to take on the new king of the 160-pound weight class, and maybe the most skilled defender in the sport.
Winky Wright was given an opportunity, and he seized it by the throat.
Big time.
That was last Saturday night in Las Vegas. Wright's dismantling of Trinidad so apparent that the reading of the final judges' scorecards was, of course, purely perfunctory. It was obvious to everyone there that Winky Wright had scored an easy, unanimous decision victory. How? He landed 262 total punches, almost five times as many as Trinidad. More than 180 of them were jabs, the punch with which Wright took away Trinidad's offense and defense both. Final scorecards. Two of the three judges found a complimentary round along the way to give to Trinidad. Dwayne Ford gave all 12 rounds to Winky Wright with the point deduction. His score became 120 to 107. The other two judges, 119 to 108. So much for Winky Wright's arrival in the 160-pound weight class.